Paul Weller and Mick Talbot are the Style Council. Their first album is My Ever-Changing Moods.
On keyboards, Weller, an ever-changing group of studio musicians. Paul Weller also runs a publishing company, a recording studio, and a record company, Respond Records.
I'm sick of all these dirty, you know, greasy rock bands, you know, in leather jackets, you know, grown men singing about how they want to rock their high school up, you know, and half naked women, you know, in their videos and how cool drugs are, you know, and how many bottles of beer they can drink a day and all that crap, you know. That's what I'm against. Because, you know, I don't find it particularly rebellious, you know. I think to get involved in some other way would be far more rebellious, you know, in a more of a political way. I just feel by categorisation that things become safe, you know. It's like once you file something away and it's got a drawer to go to, it's almost dismissed, really, you know. And I don't really like the idea of that. And I think probably one of the good things about what we've done with the Style Council is we've tried as best to avoid that, and I think we have more or less, because our style's changed so much, the actual musical style, you know. And because we cover a lot of different musical styles, I think people find it hard to categorise us. I must shoot to win and commit the sin of wanting more than I've already got. I could run away, but I'd rather stay in the warmth of your smile, lighting up my day.
Effect music can have anyway, because when it comes down to it, whether you want it to be or not, it's seen to be a part of show business or whatever phrase you want to label it with. But if you can get through to just a minority, then that's a start, or you can make someone think differently or influence them the way they might be, you know, influenced by, say, a book or something, you know. Like a lot of people read books at stages in their lives and they just think they really change their thinking. I don't see why songs can't be like that. In a way, I suppose it's like a little pretentious, but we're like sort of like film directors, and we cast a certain lineup for each individual song, you know, when we record.
We try to find as young musicians as possible, you know, mainly because I just find a lot of people work in music after they've done it for, you know, 10 years or something, you just get so cynical towards it, even just towards playing, you know, and it just ruins the spirit of a group. So when you're working with, like, say, like, the bass player has just turned 17 and the drummer is 18, they've just got so much enthusiasm, you know, and every night they want to get out. You don't get any of the, you know, it's, you know, another concert. It's just every night they want to go out and do it. And that, it's good because it rubs off on you.
Ooh, yeah.
to try and aim to be great, you know. I mean, I'm not saying that, you know, that you always succeed at it, but you've got to try and aim for that, because it is too easy just to be mediocre, you know, and most people settle for that. And I think most groups are, and they just settle for too little, and their audiences do as well. They settle for just being successful, you know, and any mug can become successful, really, you know, if you pull the right strings and make the right moves. And I'm not sure if it's enough, really. You're the best thing.
Growing older.
It's all downhill anyway, you know what I mean? So.